98.9 The Flex, the official home of your Los Angeles Lakers.
Get hip or get done.
The tall buildings of downtown Boston lighting up the nighttime sky. Welcome, folks. Thanks for tuning in to 2K Sports for the latest presentation of our NBA basketball. Kevin Harlan here, and I'm joined by Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg with David Aldridge on our sideline. A chance now to check out how the All-Star voting is shaping up.
And I tell you, the excitement starting to ratchet up a little bit as the tallies start coming in.
You look at Davis. He's not quite there, but he's very close to a spot in the starting lineup for the West.
And to have the great season he's having and still not crack the top five, that just tells you a lot about how...
And with tip-off coming up, we've got just enough time to hear from our good friend David Aldridge on the sideline. D.A., take it away.
Well, the maturity and poise of a young Jason Tatum has often been talked about. Maybe that's because his parents prepared him for the NBA from an early age in St. Louis. They had for 10 press conferences using a hairbrush as the microphone. And you can say he's been groomed for this. It's paying off, guys.
Yeah, they dotted every I and crossed every T. David, thank you. Look, these two teams are not all that familiar with each other, but when they do play, man, they've had some terrific games.
Yeah, and, you know, great rivalries, Kevin, bring out the emotion. And, you know, I think fans around the country, me included, have been looking forward to this.
Now let's check out our starters for the Los Angeles Lakers. LeBron and Davis, the incredible forward pair. And it's Caruso in at the two. And for the Celtics, Walker and Brown, they're manning the backcourt. Hayward at small forward with Tatum at the four. And it's Williams at the five. And so off the tip, it's Boston. Now Walker. At the top of the key, Williams. Brown outside. From 17 feet out. And he gets it to go, hitting off the back of the rim. Hayward's got the first points up on the board here for the Celtics. Pass to James. Nice passing here by Los Angeles. With the shot. They grab their own miss. Williams with the block. They get it back. And that one, good. Here's the Celtics with the ball. The Lakers beat them last time when these two teams met in Los Angeles.
Scoring efficiency was an issue in that one. It took them too many shots to get their points.
Yeah, and I think they just seem to be a page behind, a step slower out there all game. So one thing you've got to know about Kemba Walker is that this guy can go off at any time. A dynamic scorer that also possesses the killer instinct. And when he gets it going, watch out. It can snowball into a dominating performance.
And that one goes out of bounds. Nice touch by Tatum. Lakers have gone 1 of 3 for the field to start this one so far. And for Walker, who stayed 3 years at UConn, but he just keeps getting better on the offensive end.
Boy, Kemba Walker is one of the most dynamic little guys we've had in the league in its history. I mean, his ability to score from outside and inside, really hard to match and quite special. He's the type of player who always is surprising you on the upside. Off to a nice start here. They've hit all three from the field.
Here's Los Angeles now. It's a 5-point game. Chalk up two there.
There is a bunch to appreciate about LeBron's game. His passing is off the charts. Just look at that feed.
Last game for Boston, they picked up the W against the Cavaliers in Cleveland. Brown feeling out of it. And finished off by Brown.
Wow, look at how quick he flashes to the rim there for the finish.
Lakers have gone 2 for 4 from the field so far today. Down low. Rebound by Williams.
You know, even though it's a point-blank range shot, that's not an easy one, especially when the defense is that tight.
A nice shot by Tatum.
5 buckets without a miss. That's a fantastic start.
Come get it. Poked away. Pass to Davis. Brown outside. And a wide open look for Walker. Bangs home the trifecta. Walker's got 8.
This is as good as it gets for a first quarter in terms of shooting the basketball.
Greg, you're exactly right. I mean, everything seems to be dropping. Impressive scoring here.
And a fast break now for the Celtics. In the corner, it's Hayward. A 3 ball. A shot's good. Brown making the play. Brown's got his 3rd assist on the night.
And it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball movement.
And the Lakers decide to take their first timeout here.
Things not going their way, and he wants to just try to talk this one over.
And you know what, guys? If for nothing else, just to slip.
We've got Daniel Tice. Hayward out there with Marcus Smart. And it's Waters in at the point. That's who's in the game for the Celtics. Good work there as it goes.
He's so good at creating his own shot. He's just got an endless supply of moves. LeBron James.
Here's Waters. 8 points his last outing. And good that time. Waters got 5 points now this quarter.
And those are the kinds of plays that are just killing them right now.
Priority and goal number one has to be tightening up defense. They can't afford to give him open looks.
It puts the D in a tough spot when you have a point guard who can throw it down.
He really does, G.A. He really does put pressure on you.
And you know, guys, showing how dynamic a weapon he is for this offense, they feed off of that energy and ability to make plays. It gets them going.
And taking a quick look here at the hustle stats for Boston.
Boy, they've really amped up the pressure at the defensive end, guys, and have piled up the steals in the early going.
And the other thing that's been equally as effective is the fact that they've gotten out on the fast break. A lot of points coming in transition.
Boston making a switch here. Williams has checked in. And the Lakers also making a switch. Caruso's checked in. Here's Smart. It's hauled in by LeBron.
Tell you what, that is a missed opportunity from mid-range for sure. With as little defense as was shown, should have made that one.
Just a positive force right now for these guys. And though his team has fallen a bit short, it's not because of him.
Smart with the ball. Looking at his numbers, he averages a bit over 9 points a game. Here's Hayward. Williams against Boris. Again, the miss by the Celtics. Last game for the Celtics, they pick up the win against Cleveland.
Well, you look at the points they produced in that game. Great adjustments on the offensive end.
Boy, it's really hard to stop them when they're in a groove offensively. They were in a comfort zone all game long in that one.
Ball's checked in for Boston. Mark, you know, some players just don't need a lot of rest. They can play basketball all day, every day, and don't want to be taken out. They've all got a lot of engine in them.
Yeah, they do. 24-7 guys, we call them. They don't need a lot of fuel, and it seems like they never are out of fuel. Guys like Paul George and Russell Westbrook come to mind.
Mm-hmm. Lakers passing it around. Oh, and he plucks it off the glass. Wow. Morris, left side. That one a little long. Boston leading by 13. Smart passes to Waters. Hayward on the wing. To end the drought. Down it goes. His 3rd basket. He's now 3 for 4.
A tough cover out there. You want to close out hard on Hayward, but you also have to respect his ability to take you off the bounce.
Timeout called, the Lakers.
And team strategies closely guarded. One aspect of the game the fans aren't always privy to?
Yeah, typically there's some type of adjustment made out of a timeout. It might be major, or it could be just a slight tweak.
Here's what the Lakers are going with right now. Jeffries is checked in, and Anthony Davis is subbed in for Kyle Kuzma.
And he's clearly led the way offensively. The question is, can they ride him and get back into it?
Davis against Walker. Releases. And James pulls it down.
Usually, guys, he's going to knock that one down from there. Proficient at operating in that medium range area.
And finished off by Davis.
Just so resourceful as a player. Davis gets the job done inside in all sorts of ways. And that's one of them right there, crashing the offensive glass, getting that second chance bucket.
Walker's shot is off.
He hasn't made any threes this quarter after sinking just the one in the first.
From six away, off the mark, had a chance to trim it to single digits. Brown outside. From 12 feet out, that one falls. Brown's got 5 points now this quarter.
I like the confidence and the assurance that Brown is taking these shots with. I mean, his mid-range game is actually on point. You know, the second period's been much more kind to him than the first. I mean, let's see if he can keep it going and maintain this.
And here's Walker. A 17-point game for him in the win against the Cavaliers in Cleveland.
And he was also a terrific creator in that game as well. His assist total show you what a fantastic all-around effort it was.
Here are the Lakers. They're on a 17-7 run. Back to Davis. Over Williams. That one's in there. The Boston lead is cut down now to just 9 in the basket from Davis.
And how does he get that one to go? No idea.
I don't have an idea either. A little heat check there, but yep, he's still cooking, and Greg, he's cooking with gas.
And so it's the Boston Celtics in control with a 9-point lead to end the quarter. Looking good at this point, but wanting more. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks, Kevin. AD, you see how they're playing you in the first half. What's the adjustment going to be?
So, you know, we got to come out with a great intensity, and it starts in warm-up. So, we got to come out with a great intensity, great mindset, and try to go out there and win the third quarter.
I have never heard anyone say it starts in warm-ups until now. Thanks, AD. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks so much, Dave, for the great interview. Don't go away, folks. We'll be back for the second half of basketball right after this. If you're just joining us in this one, first half is in the books, one half to go. Lakers trail by 9. Checking out the group for Frank Vogel to start the second half. LeBron and Davis, the incredible forward pair. And it's Jeffries in at the center position. And a quick look here at some of the numbers for Brown.
In the last 5 games, you can see the trend upwards for effective field goal percentage. And it shows you how confident he's playing right now.
Celtics leading by 7. Walker the pass to Tatum. Brown outside. Releases from 15. A rebound by the Lakers.
And the well is running dry for him right now. Nothing falling.
And, you know, you can sense his frustration. This is going to be a test of his resolve here.
Here's LeBron from 13 feet. It goes down. LeBron's got his second basket of the night.
You know, for LeBron, I think that mid-range shot is an important one for him to have in his bag. It keeps the defense honest.
Williams looking around. Here's Walker. Williams trying to break free. Walker's shot is off.
You know, guys, you can tell he wants to contribute more, but his teammates have picked up the slack for him. That's what being on the team is all about.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
Well, listless and lifeless at the defensive end. I mean, especially inside. They've really got to pick up that interior defense.
Can't hit that one. So the Lakers will take it the other way.
And out of the gates here in this second half, they have not started well. 0-3.
For the tie, Hayward grabs the board.
And you could tell he thought that triple was going to fall.
Outside, Walker takes the 13-footer. Walker missing again.
You know, he just has not been himself this period. Just too inconsistent up and down at the offensive end. Well, I like this execution coming out of the half. Solid. 3-for-4 from the field so far.
So the Celtics call timeout. They're first. And Clark, when you were playing, I imagine the pre-draft process was a lot different than it is today.
No doubt about it. I mean, I came out in 1982 after my junior year, Kevin, and at that time, if you were a guy who was declaring early, you basically just had to go on whatever.
Los Angeles, they have scored 6 points from their 8 attempts at the line so far.
And 74% has been the mark for them on the season thus far.
And, you know, you don't have to tell them what their free throw numbers are. I mean, they're well aware of it, believe me.
And it's tied up with that one.
Davis is really the total package, a mobile, sharp-shooting big guy who can score from everywhere.
Now, here's Walker. He's got 8. Inside, it's stolen by Davis. And now, here comes Teague, leading the break for the lead. 2 free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. The Lakers have gone 7 of 9 from the free throw line tonight. And the free throw is good, now leading by 1. And both shots good from the stripe.
And really making the most of his opportunities there tonight. Hasn't been the struggle we sometimes see him go through.
Walker surveying the floor. Again, the miss by the Celtics.
The tough shots aren't going down for him right now, but neither are the easy ones. I mean, he's got to find the rhythm somehow.
The shot's good from Kuzma.
At the offensive end, he's been assertive and efficient, guys. A big reason why they hold this lead right now.
Outside, Walker looking to end the run. Rebounded by the Lakers.
And another miss. Oof. He's having a really ugly game.
About as ugly as you can have, you're right.
And one difference this half is that when they get to the line, they're converting.
The Los Angeles, they have shot 9 of 11 at the free throw line. This one calls for. Austin making a switch here. Brown's checked in. The Lakers also making some changes. Jeffries has checked in, and it's LeBron in for Green. 30 seconds left in the third quarter of the game. Some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, right now you just need a bucket to get some momentum.
Brown against Davis. 6 on the shot clock. Puts it up. Got it, and the Laker lead has been cut down now to just 5 on the basket from Brown.
Hey, Brown is very serious about his scoring. I mean, he's got the green light to fire up from just about anywhere out there, and he takes full advantage of it.
But if it goes, and the last second attempt does not go in for him. And we'll be back with you shortly. And a chance right now to show you our State Farm assist of the game.
And I'm glad this was the pick because I love this pass. Such a great dish. That's what I call court vision.
Yeah, and with the accuracy to go along with that vision. I mean, he put the ball in the absolute perfect spot. That's how you orchestrate it.
Well, what a terrific game it's been so far, with this fourth quarter sure to bring more pressure-packed basketball. Brown and Hayworth, they're the wing. Daniel Tice out there with Williams. And and it's Walker in at the one. That's who's in the game for the Celtics.
And, you know, Walker is really good at muscling his way through the defense. Tough to stop on the way up.
There's the pass to James. Yep, that one goes in there. And the Lakers lead by five.
Just love the focus when he gets around the rim. How huge could those 2 points be?
Ball's knocked loose. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
Boy, he keeps constant pressure on the defense. That is for sure. Walker gets to the foul line quite a bit.
And a moment here to take a look at the scoring breakdown for Los Angeles.
You know, with their fast break operating so efficiently, I mean, you can see why they've gone with it throughout the game.
And also, their second chance points have been a story all night as well. That's just pure effort and hustle.
And Davis gets it to go.
I wonder what the score would be if they weren't controlling the backboard.
And Greg, it's clearly been their edge, and in a close game like this, you look for every edge you can find.
Now Williams. Outside, Walker lets it go from deep. And Davis pulls it down. Davis has got 8 rebounds in this game. The shot comes out. Excellent D there from Williams. Celtics trail by 5. Brown, and finished off by Brown.
Just awesome speed from Brown. Blasting off towards the bucket and slamming it down.
And the Lakers call time here. And so James will bring it up for the Los Angeles Lakers. Passes it to Caruso. From the arc. Here's Davis. Lays it up off the glass. Davis has got 4 points in the quarter.
And, you know, got to admire the patience inside from Davis. Outstanding at staying under control, taking his time, and burying a quality shot. He drilled 1 from deep in the first half, doing it again here in the second.
James outside, and they double up LeBron. Caruso looking for an opening. Pass to Jeffers, to the paint. That one goes in. He's got 27. Here's Walker. Just a little under 2.5 minutes have passed now here in the fourth. To Brown. That's the 3 fly. No good that time.
You know, to cut deficits, you got to be making smart basketball plays out there. Taking care of the ball. It's not done by hoisting up bonehead threes like that one.
And the D not really doing its job there. A little slow to react to the ball getting into the paint.
Now, here's Walker. D right on him. The shot by Hayward. Wide open. Shot's good on the assist by Walker. Walker's got 3 assists in the game. And the basket is good. And the Lakers lead by 5.
And that's an example of playing big, adapting to the situation.
And sometimes that's the best policy when you're going up against a big guy. Take it to the 10. Right at him. Get to the rack.
Time called here. The Celtics decide to talk it over. They're trailing by 5. There's 1:54 left in the fourth quarter. And now we present our Jordan player of the game.
And it's been a ridiculous performance in the best sense possible. I mean, everything about his game has been working. And no matter what they've thrown at him, he's had the answer.
And let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Well, I was able to listen in on what Brad Stevens had to say to his team. He wants them to maintain their balanced attack. He told them they're doing a great job of finding space out on the perimeter, which has led to all those good shots. He likes the rhythm and the flow of this offense. He just told them, keep shooting it with confidence. Kevin?
To the middle. And he drops in the layup off the glass. And it's a 7-point Los Angeles lead.
It's basically been all him. I mean, he scored most of the points himself.
There's 1:34 left here in the fourth quarter. And he gets it to go.
That's why Walker is out here. I mean, he's got the ability to capitalize in big spots of the game.
LeBron James on the wing. The pass to Caruso. To the inside. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
Gets their money's worth from that foul. Stopping the layup and not giving up the and one.
And the second of two is good. That increases their lead to six. 1:19 left in the fourth. Walker with it. Jeffries with the rebound. Passes it to Davis. A baseline chain. And Boston with the rebound. 59 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Here's Walker. It's good. And now they trail by just four.
There isn't anybody they trust more than Walker down the stretch. He's made so many big shots over the course of his career. Add another one to the list.
There's 42 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Good! And he has brought them to within 2 points.
There's no doubt about it. Walker has got the touch.
Guys are not going to be in any rush on this possession.
Not with the lead. Now's the time to burn some clock.
Lakers passing it around. And they double up Davis. Mr. Caruso. And stolen by Tatum.
Seattle for any wasted possessions down the stretch.
The defense needs to be just as sharp, but it's not over yet.
Here's Walker. Can't cash in. And an intentional foul right there.
Yeah, you know what? Smart foul. You got to try and extend the game.
Do it. It's not over. Clock is as much a problem for them as the score is right now, so they've got to try to manage it.
So he drops them both. It's a 4-point ball game.
Good composure from the line there. Those shots sealed it.
Time called here. The Celtics decide to talk it over. They're trailing by four. 3 seconds left to play in the final quarter. Guys, your thoughts?
Well, they'll need a very quick basket out of this timeout.
Yeah, and even if they get it and then get a quick foul, I'm not sure there's enough time even under that scenario.
Deep. Offline. And so it's the Lakers who come out on top here. This was a hard-fought, well-earned victory for them, Greg. They really had to work for this win.
Yeah, that's a good point. I mean, well, weaker teams might have buckled at the end with the crowd amped up, everyone in the building kind of rooting against you. But they stood tall and pulled it out.
Well said. And that about...
Hey, it's Shaq. Great job locking down the W. I saw all those going for you on the offensive end. You smell barbecue chicken or what?
Honestly, big fella, I'm getting that chicken with the blue cheese. But you know it's all the same. I'm just happy to get out and get the win. I thought we did a great job of creating mismatches, exploiting switches. The timing of our plays was on point. But really, we maximized what we did well as a group.
That barbecue chicken and blue cheese? Gotta try that combination.
Listen up, listen up, listen up. All right, tonight's game ball goes to the guy who left it out there. The guy who said, I don't care what I gotta do, we're not losing this game. Che, get up here. Nice work, man.
Appreciate it, coach. Hey, man, there is another group of guys I'd rather go to war with, all right? I'll do this for y'all, all right? They don't want no smoke. Let's do this, man.
Yeah.